everybody. So I shared not long ago a picture of this journal page. Just, you know, some kind of fun things I was just, you know, working on in my journal. Honestly, this is just kind of a wipe-off page. The whole thing is a wipe-off page. So the paint in the background was I was wiping off a brush. The washi tape came in some Happy Mail, and I stuck it on here. And then I put some music note paper on here. I thought now we'd spend a little bit of time pulling the whole thing together and actually making some kind of journal page out of it. So we're going to use my Arrow stencil, which is one of my new stencils. And I was playing with it earlier. So first thing that we want to do is take this, and we're going to wipe it off. I'm going to get out a baby wipe. This is the gold metallic dimensional cream that I mixed up. Hey, that's a good name for it. that I mixed up in a previous video. I will try to remember to link it in the description below. If I forget, somebody tell me. So we're going to clean this off really quick. Oops. You want to clean this stuff off of your stencils. You don't want to leave any dimensional texturing gel medium type product to dry on your stencils. It'll clog up your stencils at some point, and it'll be a lot harder to clean it off. So just go ahead and clean it off right away. So there we go. All right. So now what we're going to do is I'm going to take my Arrow stencil and some painter's tape. And I love my Arrow stencil, but I think for this project, I want to isolate a certain design in the stencil by masking off the rest. Now, I initially thought I would do this part, the little three dots, this part with the dots. And I may do, but I think to start with, I think I want this end part of the arrow where it sort of looks like chevrons or arrows. So I'm going to take some painter's tape. To do that, or do I want to just cut it off like that? Okay, then I'm going to take my page and my dimensional cream. I'm going to hold the stencil down pretty tight to the page, and I'm going to push this through the stencil. Like that. That one's a little messy, but that's okay. I wasn't holding it down tight enough, so see? You can, of course, do this on paper and let it dry and then collage it on, which might be a little easier, especially if your journal is not flat, like mine is not really flat anymore. I think that's good. I want to stop there. So I'm going to do that. Now, and you need to let this dry completely before you do anything else. So we're going to do that, but I want to take the rest of this cream and I'm going to take one of these pieces of paper and I'm going to use the opportunity that I have by having all this extra cream to create some more collage paper. You could do the whole arrow, take the tape off, or you could just do the parts. This cream really won't keep. So it's best if you make it that you just go ahead and use it all up. Don't try not to make too much more than what you're going to need to get your page done. And again, if you want your stenciling with the cream to come out perfect, then you really want to not use too much of it. Make sure it's flat to the paper. Like you see these over here, they're really nice and crisp. I take a little more time with it than I just did. But anyway, I'm okay with what came out. I am going to let that dry and we're going to finish with our page and I'll be right back. Okay, so you're going to see some footage right now. I'm going to cut to the footage right here where you see me working here on the background. Now our melted metal embellishments have dried completely and now I'm able to go in and around and over them with some golden high flows and just a little bit of water, and I'm really just letting the paint drip and do what it may and add more texture to the background. The only thing that I am doing is I'm blotting it off the top of our liquid metal embellishments so that they continue to shine through. So once you do this, like with the embellishments, the melted metal look, we have to let this dry completely and then we can move forward. Couple of different quotes out of my word box that I think are going to be great on this page. And this is all completely dry. I actually just let it dry overnight, so it's nice and dry. So now it's time to embellish it. So I pulled a couple things out. I have no idea which I want to use, but we'll see. I have a couple of these sort of, I don't know, borders and chipboard and laser cut wood. I've got this bin of this stuff. This is, I think, chipboard. And I'm not sure which one I want to put. I'm thinking I actually want to use the littler one. This one's nice and all, but I keep thinking I want to do that, which I might want to do. So let's just do that, and let's not think about it too much. And let's just create and have fun, because that's what it's all about, right? Okay, so I'm going to cut this a bit shorter. And hopefully in a way that I can save that little piece and use that again. I think I kind of want to put it there. Now this is also going to have to be trimmed because it's going to be too big to fit in the seam here. I also, though, have this sheet of black. It's from Recollections. It's a corrugated paper. It's black and it has... It doesn't have a black core, it has a brown core. I'm kind of thinking I want a piece of this on here. Yeah, see, it's got a like craft paper core. But I'm thinking I want to just tear it. Well, hope I want to tear it because I just did. So hopefully I want to tear it. And I'm thinking I want to. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to trim this. Question is, how do I want to trim it? I think I want to just trim it in half. Hope I do, because I'm going to. Okay. And actually, I think we're going to use this piece up here. Yep. I'm going to use this down here. And I'm doing this in real time because I know some of you like kind of prefer to have that. I have some other things here, but you know what? I'm not going to even get them out because I like the way this looks. So let's get this all attached and or glued down. So we're going to use the Tim Holtz Tiny Attacher for the corrugated cardboard. I like the industrial look of just stapling things to the page. And I'm not worried about the staples showing through to the other side, especially because that page has staples on it. I'm going to get this on here, and I want this to like hang off the bottom. I like the way that looks. Okay. I have a bunch of like clothing tags that I've recently taken off things, just laying on my desk because I haven't put them away yet. Not really for any other reason, except that they just didn't end up where they were supposed to. Okay, I want to glue these down. So we're going to get out some heavy gel medium, not because we need it for the die cut paper, because we do need it for the chipboard, and a palette knife. It won't hurt the die cut paper at all, but that thick cheap chipboard, you're going to have trouble sticking down if you don't use a good heavy glue. And I'm going to stay. Okay, you can't see that. I've got the palette. Oh, yeah, you can. The palette knife's balanced over there. So let's stick like one staple in there. Okay, maybe two. There we go. So I want to get like at least most of it stuck down well. At least in the fold here, for sure. I don't care if some little pieces over here are sticking up. It's not going to hurt anything. Okay, let's do that up here. I'm going to do it this way. I'm thinking too much. I need to just stick it on there. This is Golden's Extra Heavy Gel. You don't have to have Golden. Use what you have. I understand that Amsterdam Acrylics makes a really nice heavy gel medium, so use what you can get and or have. I have this big jar of Golden that I'm trying to use up. Okay, and this dries clear, so you don't have to worry about the extra white bits that are on here. They're not going to show. Okay. I'm going to leave the glue open for right now. I want to trim my words and see how they're going to work into our page. And kind of make double sure that we're not going to use any other embellishments on the page. I don't think so. It's pretty busy already. I'm just giving these a nice, neat trim. Now, you don't, of course, have to. You could leave them messy and ragged. You could tear them out of your book or magazine. I kind of like that there. And then what if we put this down here? Yep. I like that. I like the way that looks. All right, let's get that down there. We're going to just use the gel medium because we have it out. A scrap piece of paper and put the gel medium on the back of this other part of this quote that I want to use. Oops, there we go. An old gift card or Starbucks card, something like that, is really great for pushing your items into the gel medium so that they stick really well. Oops. And of course, as soon as I say that, this doesn't want to stick. Of course not. I like the way that looks very much. Okay. I don't even know if it needs anything else. That's pretty busy, but I do know a little something that I want to do. So I have another high flow color here that I didn't use yet, and this is called Shading Gray, and it's like a transparent gray, and this is the same as this. They now call these high flow acrylics. They used to call them airbrush colors, and this is an old bottle which says airbrush color, but they have the same color still in the high flows. It's called Shading Gray, and I'm going to get a tiny little brush. And I'm going to take some of this. I'm going to actually pull the top off of it. And I'm going to just stick the brush right in the bottle. Some water. I'm going to need that scrap piece of paper again. It dries a lot lighter and more opaque than it looks like right now on the page. You're going to have to just trust me. But you should have your baby wipes handy. And then I'm going to just, you can use a squirt bottle or you can just drip some water. I'm using the water that's in my water jar here for my paintbrushes. I have a little more control over where the water goes and the paint goes if I do it this way. So that would be why I'm doing it this way, just in case anybody's wondering. Okay, now we're going to take a baby wipe. Oh, I'm going to have to get some more baby wipes out soon. And I'm going to just dab it off where I don't want it or if there's too much big puddles that I don't like. It's going to absorb into some of the paper, but you know what? I'm okay with that. Okay, there we go. I really like the way that page turned out. I hope you do too. And above all, I hope it gave you guys some ideas of what you can do with just a few simple bits and pieces, a stapler, and some gold paint. So there you have it. Have a great day. Support my channel if you can. Or join one of my Facebook groups. The links for my Etsy shop, the Facebook groups, my Happy Mail address, all that's in the description below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe if you're new here. And of course, leave a comment if you would like to have a question answered or anything else. And above all, have a great day. Do something nice for yourself because you deserve it. And I'll see you later. Bye, guys.